this video, we're going to take a look at keyframing color corrections in Final Cut Pro. This can be very useful if your lighting changes in your shot, or you want to change the mood of your clip, like the one at the start of this video. Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge, and welcome back to my channel. Before we get started, if there's any effect, topic, or anything else Final Cut Pro related you'd like to see me discuss in one of my future videos, please let me know in the comments below. I just want to make sure my future videos focus on topics you guys are interested in. So let's take a look at the first clip in my timeline. This clip starts out with good outdoor lighting, but transitions into an indoor low light scene. First, I'll set my playhead over the outdoor part of the clip, set up my space for color correction, and color correct my clip. Now, when I play it back, pay attention to the waveforms. When the camera moves into low light, the correction I applied to the clip is now much too dark, crushing blacks, and we lose a lot of detail in the image. This is where the ability to keyframe color correction comes in handy. Now, this is only possible if you're running Final Cut Pro version 10.4 or higher. If you're still on 10.3, this option will not be available to you, but there is a way around that, and I'll show you at the end of this video. First thing we need to do is add the initial keyframe. Set the playhead right before the camera moves inside, and in the inspector, beside Color Wheels 1, click the keyframe button to add a keyframe. Next, move the playhead ahead to where the camera is completely inside the building. Now, adjust your color correction to suit your lighting in your clip. So now, we have one correction at the start of the clip, and another color correction at the end of our clip. If I press Ctrl V to open the video animation, and skim between the two keyframes, you can see the correction controls gradually move between the two corrections for a nice smooth transition, instead of an abrupt change. Let's try it again on the next clip. This time, instead of applying a color correction, we'll apply a color grade to change the mood of this clip. Same as before, I'll set the playhead where I want the change to start, and in the inspector, make sure the color tab is selected, and from the drop-down menu, select my preferred correction method. I don't want to make any changes to my clip, so without applying any corrections, I'll add a keyframe here. Next, I'll move my playhead a couple seconds ahead, and apply a color grade to my clip. To make this look and feel even more dramatic, we can add some background music and sound effects, even retime the last portion of the clip. Let's play that back and see how it looks. Now, if you're still on version 10.3, you'll not be able to add keyframes to color corrections. In this case, what you have to do is first, blade your clip into two parts. Next, apply your different color corrections to one or both clips if necessary. And last, to smooth out the abrupt jump between the two different looks, add a cross dissolve transition between your clips. Ripple trim the length of your transition to adjust the timing of this effect. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, let me know by hitting the like button or in the comments below. And if you're new here, check out the rest of my channel for more Final Cut Pro tutorials. New videos uploaded weekly, so make sure to hit the subscribe button so you don't miss them. Thanks for watching. I'll see you back here again next week.